Is the Internal Revenue Service calling for an investigation of churches to placate an atheist group? That's the charge by some religious freedom advocates. A recent letter from the tax agency to the Justice Department claims that 99 churches merit a, quote, high priority examination for so-called illegal electioneering. In an article on National Review Online, Quinn Hillier writes that the IRS sent that letter in reference to a lawsuit filed against it by the Freedom From Religion Foundation. That lawsuit called on the IRS to enforce prohibitions against churches that endorse candidates from the pulpit. The foundation has since dropped its suit. And joining us now with more is Jordan Sekulow, the executive director of the American Center for Law and Justice. Jordan, what's your take on all this? Did the IRS give in to pressure by the Freedom From Religion Foundation to avoid a lawsuit?
Well, Mark, as we always say when it comes to these very radical atheist groups, we call them angry atheists, like Freedom From Religion Foundation, they rarely ever win in court when they actually have to go through the legal process. They win by filing lawsuits and then getting these, quote, settlements or getting people to change their policies. In this case, what we have to be concerned about is whether or not this is the Freedom From Religion Foundation making more of a victory than is truth, or the IRS, and what's more dangerous, the IRS in a way now having some way to legitimize this retargeting of churches and the speech that's going on at those churches. And it's not just about endorsing candidates from the pulpit. This was about even talking about issues like traditional marriage, like pro-life issues, and of course, just recently, things like the HHS mandate. So we're not just talking about endorsing candidates from the pulpit. We're talking about critical issues to the community.
Well, do you think the IRS is actually going to go through with this and investigate these churches on those charges?
You know, it's interesting. The IRS has never really fully utilized this power that they claim to have. And there's a law called the Johnson Amendment passed to prohibit churches from directly engaging in political activity for candidates. So that's just your pastor at the pulpit endorsing a candidate. There's been a ban on that. But other issues like promoting or talking about hot button topics, that's something entirely different. So if the IRS was to use this to justify now implementing a policy of going after churches because they discuss things like life and like marriage, that would put us into a new realm, if you will, of IRS intimidation. And what you saw here makes me nervous because of now what we've seen the IRS doing to conservative groups, this targeting. They will legitimize it and justify it any way they can. And I have to wonder if this settlement here, in this withdrawn lawsuit, will be a way for the IRS to then legitimize going after churches that they wouldn't previously do.
Well, let's talk big picture here. What will be the impact on freedom of religion and freedom of speech?
Well, you know, anytime the IRS is involved, people get scared. But I do want to be clear right now. The IRS is on its heels now more than ever. Because of all the attention on the Tea Party targeting and the conservative targeting, the IRS has had a tough job. I mean, the division that would enforce this, Mark, is the same division that Lois Lerner headed until she retired. So the division, the tax-exempt organizations, they also, Freedom From Religion Foundation, wanted churches to have to file what's called 990s, what 501c3s have to file each year. Churches are exempt from that. There was no decision there, so they didn't win on that issue. That's something to look forward to in the future to see if they try to re-challenge the IRS on that. The big picture, though, is this. Will you be afraid of the IRS, or will you do what you've been doing without problem, and you know that there's groups like us around to defend you if the IRS or a group like Freedom From Religion Foundation is trying to shut down your speech, which you have the absolute right to make?
For our audience, clarify for us, Jordan, what the law actually says about churches and political activities.
Well, churches fall under the broad 501c3 category of exempt organizations, but they are treated even differently. Houses of worship do not have to file regular 990 returns. That's the annual reports to the IRS that a group like us, the ACLJ, has to file each year, and other nonprofits have to file. So they're exempted. We've always had treated churches and religious institutions differently than houses of worship specifically, differently than others. That's just part of our history and how we have worked. Now, there are prohibitions on what C3s can do. They can't directly engage in political campaigns, and they can't directly endorse candidates. And in the church's situation, the distinction is this: a pastor going to the pulpit and endorsing a candidate could be putting the church at risk. And that was before this case. Yet that same pastor can, outside of the church, endorse a candidate, as long as it's the church is clearly distinguished from the endorsement. So it's not as if individuals, by becoming members of the clergy or the pastoral staff, lose their free speech rights and their First Amendment rights. So there are things the church has, churches have to be careful about. But as long as they're operating basically the same way they have been, if the IRS, if this, we'll know if this is some kind of new intimidation strategy if the IRS starts contacting more churches.
Is the IRS under the Obama administration biased against conservative and religious groups?
We know they're biased against conservatives and those who would have more of a Christian conservative, pro-life groups. We represent a pro-life group who was targeted, like the Tea Party groups, treated the same way because of their pro-life views. So absolutely, it's a time to be concerned. The positive is that the IRS is under so much scrutiny that, you know, it'd be very tough for them, I think, to even try to start a policy like this. Hopefully I'm right. But that being said, you know, nothing has been real shocking lately when it comes to the animosity that the people at the IRS in charge of this very division a year ago had towards conservatives and conservative Christians.
Okay, well, we'll leave it there. Jordan Sekulow, thanks so much for your insights.
Thanks, Mark.